In this video, I'm starting type 3 problems, which are problems in which friction will be acting on the inclined plane. And to start this, we are starting the first topic of angle of repose. And the definition of this angle of repose is the minimum angle of inclination of a rough inclined plane at which if any block is kept, then it will start the slipping. So it has two definitions, that we can say that this is the minimum angle of inclination for which any block which is kept on the inclined plane will start to slip down, or we can say that it is the maximum possible angle of inclination of any inclined plane for which any block which is placed on that inclined plane will not slide down. Okay, so we can say these two definitions simultaneously. Now, to calculate this value of angle of repose, we must draw the free body diagram. So this will be the normal reaction acting on the block N, and this will be the component of mg, which is mg cos theta, mg cos alpha, and this will be the component of mg, which is mg sin alpha. And to prevent this block from slipping, friction will be acting in the reverse direction towards backside, and this friction will be F. Now, when this block is on the verge of slipping, I mean to say when this block is just on the verge of slipping and it is just starting the slipping, then this friction will be acting to its peak value F max, and its peak value will be mu into N. Now N is already equal to mg cos alpha, therefore F will be equal to mu mg cos alpha, and this is the F max also. So when this mg sin alpha is balanced by the maximum friction, then beyond this point, if we tilt the inclined plane, then block will start to slip, and therefore mg, to find out the boundary condition, to find out the boundary angle, mg sin alpha should be equal to F max, and mg sin alpha should be equal to mu mg cos alpha, and cancelling out mg, we can get tan alpha is equal to mu, and alpha is equal to tan inverse of mu, which we have already studied as angle of friction. So there is a relationship between these two angles, that if a plane surface which is a rough surface has some angle of friction, let's suppose theta, then if we tilt that rough surface with a block kept on it, then that block will start to slip down when we are tilting that surface to an angle which is exactly equal to its angle of friction. For example, if some surface has an angle of friction of 37 degree with a block kept on it, it means that if we tilt that flat surface to 37 degree, so till 37 degree, the block kept on that surface will not slide down, and after that, it will start to slide down. So, angle of repose is that angle which, after which, any block which is kept on the inclined plane will start to slide down, and its value is equal to the angle of friction also. Okay guys, so we will be coming up with more videos which are based on the friction on the inclined plane, and I hope you got this concept easily. Thank you. Now in this question, we need to find out the acceleration of this block as shown, and we need to find out the acceleration for two different values of mu, where mu is the coefficient of friction. So we need not to draw the free body diagram in these cases. We can just directly check the angle of repose with the mu. I'm going to show you how. So we know that 10 alpha, where angle of repose is alpha, is equal to mu, and mu in the first case is equal to 0.6. So angle of repose should be equal to 0.6, but the actual angle of inclination is equal to theta is equal to 37 degree, and tan 37 is equal to 3/4, which is 0.75. So we can see that the actual inclination, which is 10/37, is greater than 10 alpha angle of repose. So the value of 10/37 is 0.75 and the value of 10 alpha is 0.6. So we can easily come to the conclusion that this block will start slipping down because actual inclination is greater than the angle of repose. So block will start to slip down. Now, if block will start to slip, then the acceleration of block can easily be calculated by drawing the free body diagram, as this is mg sin 37 is acting on the block and this force is friction. So friction will be mu mg cos 37. There will be a normal reaction which we need not to write, and the acceleration of the block is A. So we can write the equation as mg sin 37 minus mu mg cos 37, and it is equal to ma, and cancelling out m with m, then g sin 37 minus mu cos 37 will be equal to a. So we can, if in these kind of problems, if block is sliding down on the inclined plane, then we will directly say that the acceleration of block will be g into sin theta minus mu cos theta, where theta is the actual value of inclined plane angle, and this acceleration will be in the downward direction. So this acceleration will be 10 into sin 37 is 3/5 minus mu. Mu is 0.6 into cos 37 is 4/5. So A will be equal to 6 minus 4.8. So A will be equal to 1.2 meters per second square. Let me check again. Yeah, so this will be 1.2 meters per second square. Now we come on the second case. In the second case, it is given that mu is equal to 0.8. So tan alpha, the angle of repose, is equal to mu, is equal to 0.8. And tan theta, where theta is the actual angle of inclination, is 0.75. So we know that tan alpha, which is angle of repose, is greater than actual inclination, and actual inclination is less than the angle of repose, because tan alpha is equal to 0.8 and actual inclination is 0.75. So this block will not slide down, because for sliding it is necessary that the actual inclination should be greater than the angle of repose. But here is the different case. So this block will not slide down, and the acceleration of the block will be zero. And again, the friction acting on this block will be not be to its peak value. In fact, friction will be acting just to balance the mg sin alpha. So friction will be equal to mg sin alpha, sin theta in fact. Alpha I am taking as angle of repose, but theta is the actual inclination. So the friction acting in this case will be mg sin 37. Okay, now we move on the next question. In this question, there are two blocks A and B, and both have different coefficient of friction on the same inclined plane, and the angle of inclination, as you can see, is 37 degree, and we have to find out the accelerations of these blocks. Now, to solve these kind of problems, we need to examine each of the block individually moving on this inclined plane. So if I assume that only block B is kept alone on this inclined plane, then what would happen? Then I can say that for block B, tan alpha, which is angle of repose, is equal to mu is equal to, which is 0.6. It is lesser than tan theta, which is actual angle of inclination, and theta is 37 degree here. So I'm writing there 37 degree. Its value is 0.75. So I can see that friction is not sufficient. Friction is not enough to prevent block B from sliding down. So block B will slide down with an acceleration of AB is equal to G sine 37 minus mu B cos 37. Now, if I put the values, G is 10, sin 37 is 3 by 5, mu B is 0.6, and cos 37 is 4 by 5. So, this is the acceleration of block B if it would have moving alone on this inclined plane. Now, same assumption is for block A, and I am assuming that block A is kept alone on this inclined plane. Then for block A, 10 alpha, which is equal to mu, where alpha is the angle of repose, and mu is equal to 0.8, and obviously it is greater than 1037 degree, which is actual angle of inclination. So I can say that friction is enough to prevent block B, in fact block A, from sliding down. So acceleration of block A would have been zero. Now for this situation in which A is being kept behind the B and they are not sticking to each other, then we can say that B will move independently with the acceleration which is shown in this equation, and the acceleration of A will be zero, and the friction acting on the block B will be the maximum friction which can act on it, and it would be mu B into m g cos 37. But for block A, the friction will be self-adjusting as there is no requirement of maximum friction to prevent A from sliding. Therefore, the friction which will be actually acting on the block A will be equal to the mg sin alpha for block A, because there is no requirement of maximum friction for block A to prevent it from sliding. So, this was the important question of inclined plane, and I'll come up with more these kind of problems in next videos. Thank you. In this question, if I assume block A alone on the inclined plane, then for block A moving alone on the inclined plane, I can say that tan alpha, which is angle of repose, is equal to mu, and it is 0.6. Mu is 0.6. It is less than tan 37, which is 0.75. So block A will move if it would have been moving on this inclined plane alone, and its acceleration will be g sine 37 degree minus mu A cos 37 degree. So its acceleration would be g is 10, sine 37 is 3/5, mu A is 0.6, and cos 37 is 4/5. This would have been its acceleration if it would have been moving alone on this inclined plane. Now same analysis for block B. So if block B would have been moving alone on this inclined plane, then I can say that tan alpha, which is equal to mu is equal to 0.8, is greater than tan 37, which is 0.75, and therefore friction is sufficient to prevent block B from sliding, and therefore the acceleration of block B will be 0. So block B, if was moving on the inclined plane alone, would be in the state of rest and would be in the equilibrium. But block A, if kept alone on this inclined plane, it would have been accelerating downwards with an acceleration AA, which I have calculated. But for the situation shown that A is kept behind B, so A should push the block B, and we have to check the situation that whether due to the push of A the system will move or not. Now I am pretty much sure in this situation that B will not accelerate over the A, and B will not move faster, obviously, because if B would have been kept alone, then it would not be moving on the inclined plane. So I can say that either they will not move as a system, or either they will move as a system. So we need to check that whether they will move as a system or not. So for checking that, I'm drawing this inclined plane, and I'm drawing the complete mass as 2m, and 2mg sine 37 is acting downwards, and friction FA and FB is acting in the reverse direction. I am considering the maximum values of friction because I need to check that whether they will move as a system or not. So 2mg sine 37 is equal to, this is, I am solving 2mg sine 37, it is 2 into m, and g is g, and sine 37 is 3/5. So if I put the value of g as 10, then it would be 12m. You can see that if g is 10, then 10/5 is 2, 2 and 2 is 4, 4 and 3 is 12. So this is 12m. Now I will check FA plus FB. Now FA will be mu A, which means 0.6, 0.6 into mg into cos 37, and FB will be 0.8 into mg into cos 37. So FA plus FB is equal to, taking out mg common, mg is 10, cos 37 is 4/5, and 0.6 plus 0.8 is 1.4. So this is 2, and FA plus FB is equal to 8 into 1.4. Now 8 into 1.4 will be 11.2, and m, and therefore the mg, 2mg sine 37 is 12m. So I can say that that 2mg sine 37 is greater than FA plus FB, which is the combined friction which can act on these blocks. So the system will move with some acceleration, and the common acceleration will be A will be 12m minus 11.2m, which means the accelerating force mg sine 2mg sine 37 minus opposing force, which is friction, divided by the mass, which is 2m. So this will be 0.4 meters per second square. This will be the acceleration of this system. Now we move on the next problem. Now in this question, there is a different set of values of mu A and mu B. So I can see that mu A is 0.8, and it is greater than 10 37, which is 0.75. Therefore, friction is sufficient to prevent sliding of block A. Therefore, if block A would have been kept alone on this inclined plane, then its acceleration would be 0. Now, same situation is for the block B, that its mu is also greater than actual inclination, which is 10 37 degree, and it is 0.75. So the acceleration of block B will also be 0 if it would have been kept alone on this inclined plane. Now they are kept together on this inclined plane, and A's both are touching each other. So if friction is sufficient enough to prevent their sliding when they are kept alone, then in this case also friction will prevent their sliding, and they will not slide on this inclined plane, as well as A will not push B. Therefore, the normal reaction between A and B will also be 0 in this case. Okay, now we move on the next question. In this question, these blocks are connected with a rope, and their coefficient of frictions are given to us. This angle of inclination of inclined plane is 37 degree. So for starting this problem, I need to check whether they will move on this inclined plane when kept alone or not. So for block A, if block A has been kept alone on this inclined plane, then its mu A, which is equal to 0.6, is less than 10 alpha, 10 37 degree, which is 0.75. So I can say that for block A, friction is not sufficient enough to prevent its sliding. Therefore, its acceleration will be g into sine 37 minus mu A cos 37 degree. Okay, I'm writing it again, that its acceleration will be AA is equal to g sine 37 minus mu A cos 37. Now for block B, I can say that mu B, which is equal to 0.7, is also less than 10 37, which is equal to 0.75. So again, I can say that friction is not sufficient to prevent block B from sliding down, and therefore its acceleration B will also be equal to g sine 37 minus mu B cos 37 degree. But we also know that mu A is less than mu B, because mu A is 0.6 and mu B is 0.7. So if mu A is less than mu B, then we can say that AA will be greater than AB. So block A will move faster than block B. Now in this case, block A is being kept behind block B, and if A will move faster than B, then this rope will slack down, and due to rope slacking, the tension in the rope will become zero. Rope slacks. because A is moving faster than B, and their accelerations will be independent. AA will be equal to G is 10, sine 37 is 3 by 5, minus mu A is 0.6, cos 37 is 4 by 5. This would be the acceleration of block A, and for AB, it is G is 10, sine 37 is 3 by 5 again, minus mu B is 0.7, and cos 37 is 4 by 5. So they will move independently, as the rope has no role to play in this situation, because its tension becomes zero and they will move independently. Now we move on to the next problem. In this problem, I have interchanged the values of mu, and again if I check for the alone movement of the blocks on this inclined plane, then for block A, mu A, which is 0.7, is less than tan 37 degree, which is 0.75. So if mu is less than tan 37, then friction is not enough to prevent sliding, and therefore the acceleration of A will be equal to G sine 37 degree minus mu A cos 37 degree. Now for block B, mu B, which is equal to 0.6, is also less than 1037, which is equal to 0.75. So again, its acceleration will be G sine 37 minus mu B cos 37 degree. So they will move if they will, they were be kept alone on this inclined plane. So, but the situation says that mu B is less than mu A, and therefore we can say that acceleration of B will be greater than acceleration of A if they were moving alone on this inclined plane. But they are restricted to move together because they are connected with a rope. And if B is moving faster alone than A, then this means that B, when A and B when connected with the rope, then rope will have some tension and the system will moving down with some acceleration. So we know that in this situation they will move with a common acceleration, and they will move as a system. So the acceleration of the system can be calculated as 2mg sine 37 plus mg sine 37. So it is 3mg sine 37 minus fa plus fb. Fa is mu a into mg cos 37, and fb is mu b into 2mg cos 37 degree divided by the total mass, which is 3m. So A system will be equal to 3 into m into g is 10, sine 37 is 3 by 5, minus mu A is 0.7, and m g is 10, cos 37 is 4 by 5, plus mu b is 0.6 into 2m into g is 10, cos 37 is again 4 by 5, divided by 3m. So this will be the acceleration of the system, and they will move with the same acceleration. Now if I need to find out the tension T of the rope, then I can write down the equation of a single block. So for this block, I'm writing down the equation that T plus mg sine 37 degree minus friction is mu a mg cos 37 degree is equal to m into a system. We have already calculated A system, and by substituting the value of A system in this equation, we can find out the value of tension T. So this was the important one, and I'll move on the next question now. In this question, both mu A and mu B are equal to each other and they are equal to 0.5. And we also know that mu A or mu B, which is 0.5, is not sufficient to prevent the sliding down, because 1037 is 0.75 and mu A is 0.5, which means that this system will move down the inclined plane, and both blocks, if they were kept alone on this inclined plane, will move down the inclined plane with the same acceleration. AA and AB will be same, which is G sine 37 minus mu. Mu, I'm taking mu as this, so mu cos 37. Now, if they are moving with the same acceleration on this inclined plane, and even though they are connected with the rope, then rope will have no part to play in the situation, and therefore the tension in the rope will be zero. Although they are connected with the rope, but they will be moving with the same acceleration on this inclined plane together also. You can find out the fact that if we write the combined equation for both the blocks, I can say that 2mg sine 37 will be acting on the system in the downward direction, minus friction is same for both the blocks, so I'm writing 2mg into mu into cos 37, which is equal to 2ma. So A will be equal to g sine 37 minus mu cos 37. So it is same as we have already calculated before, and this leads to an important conclusion that if a system is moving if a system of two blocks is moving together in the effect of external force with some acceleration with which it would have been moving alone in that situation, then if they are connected with some rope or some rod, then the tension in that rope or rod will be zero, and rope and rod will not play any part in this situation. So I can say that the tension in this rope will be zero and their acceleration will be same, and it is g sine 37 minus mu cos 37. Now we move on the next problem.